Hello friends, in this video we are going to solve some GATE previous year's question from the chapter Linear Programming. So friends, this is a GATE question from the year 2014 set 3. So what the question is saying, consider an objective function z x1 x2 equals 3 x1 plus 9 x2, and they have also given the constraints, which is x1 plus 2 x2 is less than equal to 4, x1 plus x2 is less than equal to 8, and x1 and x2 is greater than 0, which means non-negative value. So first of all friends, I will plot the value, and they have asked the maximum value of the objective function. So friends, let's say I am trying to draw a graph. This is x1 and this is x2. So x1 plus 2x2 is less than equals to 4. So when x1 is 0, x2 is 2. So let's say this is 2 friends. And when x2 is 0, x1 is 4. So this is 4. So first of all friends, I will try to draw a line like, sorry. So this is x2 and this is a line. Let's say this is going to 2 and 4. And now the second equation is x1 plus x2 is 8. So friends, this is 8 and this is 8. Basically it's a simple equation, x plus y is equal to 8. So the intercept will be 8 and 8. Similarly, I will join this line also. So this is x1 plus 2 x2 equals to 8. So what the question is, less than. So this is basically, this is the area. This is the area. So the common area is this one friends, because x1 and x2 is greater than 0. So now friends, what they're saying, the maximum value of the objective function. So see friends, there are only three nodes. One is this one, and other is this one, and other is this one. So this coordinate is 0, 0. So the value of is z equals to 0. For this, it is 0, 2. So for z at 0, 2, it will be 9 to the 18. And for this point, which is 4, 0, z at 4, 0 will be 4, 3, 12. So the maximum value of the z is 18. So the right answer is 18. Now friends, moving to the next question. So friends, this is again a GATE question from the year 2014, set 4. The question is the total number of decision variables in the objective function of an assignment problem. See friends, this is an assignment problem, they have clearly mentioned, of size n cross n, which means n jobs and n machine. Basically friends, for an assignment problem, the number of decision variables is m cross n, which is mn. This is the number of, for an m cross n function, the number of decision variables is mn. So for particular case, for this particular case, here m is equals to n. So the number of decision variables will be n square. So the right answer is A. It is n square. Now moving to the next question. So friends, this is again a question in which they have asked maximize z equals to 3x1 plus 2x2, and they are given the conditions minus of 2x1 plus 3x2 is less than 9, x1 minus 5x2 is greater than or equal to minus 20, and x1 and x2 are greater than or equal to 0. So again, I will try to draw a curve in which I will try to draw the points. So friends, if I take the first equation, minus of 2x1 plus of 3x2 is less than equals to 9. So when x1, let's say this is x1 and this is x2. So when x1 is 0, x2 is 3. So this is 3. And when x2 is 0, x1 is minus of 4.5. So let's say I am extending it this point. So it will be, if I try to join the curve, it is this one. And what they are saying, that the value is less than 9. So friends, the value will be this one. This is less than 9. Now friends, the second equation, x1 minus 5x2 is greater than or equal to minus of 20. So when I take x1 as 0, so if you take x1 is 0, x2 will be 4. So this is 4. And when x2 is 0, x1 is minus of 20. So again, I will try to join the curve something like this. And it is greater than minus 20. So friends, the only way to check whether it will be on this side or on the that side, assign the value 0, 0. So when you put the value of 0 and 0, 0 is greater than equal to minus 20. Yes, 0 is greater than minus 20. So again, this is the reason. So as you can see, the solution is unbounded. So the correct answer is our problem has an unbounded solution. The right answer is option A. Now friends, moving to the next question. So friends, this is a gate question from the year 2016. It's a very similar type of question. As you can look at the options also, they have given the same options as in previous questions only. So only thing is they have changed the data. So now what the question for this particular case is saying that we have to maximize z equals to 15x1 plus 20x2. The conditions are 12x1 plus 4x2 is greater than or equal to 36. And the second condition is 12x1 minus 6x2 is less than or equal to 24. So again, I will plot the curve. So let's say this is x1 and this is x2. So friends, let's say I'm taking x1 is 0. So when x1 is 0, x2 is 9. And when x2 is 0, x1 is 3. So I will first try to plot it. So friends, let's say this is the curve. And the value, what they are saying, greater than equals to 36. So it is this reason, because if you put the value of x1 and x2 as 0, it is less than as 36. So this is the area. Now second case, 12x1 minus 6x2 is less than 24. So when I put x1 as 0, so we will be getting x2 as minus 4. So let's say this is minus 4. And when you put x2 as 0, you will be getting x1 as 2. So friends, this is the basically curve. And they are saying it is less than 24. So 0, 0 will satisfy it. So it is this area. So again, friends, if you look at the curve, x1 and x2 greater than 0, this is the reason, and it is an unbounded reason. So the solution is again an unbounded solution. So the correct answer is B. The above LPP, that is linear programming problem, has an unbounded solution. So the right answer is option B. Now moving to the next question. So friends, this is a gate question from the year 2017. So what the question is saying, two models P and Q of a product. So let's say I am trying to solve this by making a table so that the information which they have given will be clearly understood by you. So friends, the question is two models P and Q of a product earn profits of rupees 100 and rupees 80 per piece. So P is earning rupees 100 and Q is earning rupees 80 per piece. So they have given the production times for P and Q are 5 hours and 3 hours respectively, and the total production time available is 150 hours. So let's say I am considering, let's say P as X variable and Q as Y variable. So now friends, 5 into X, that is X is P, and 3 into Y is 150 hours. So because 5 hours is taken by P, that is 5x, and 3 hours is taken by Q, so this is 3y, and the total available time is 150 hours. So let's say this is less than equals 150. It is because 150 is the maximum time available. And the next question is, for a total batch size of 40. So they have mentioned that x plus y is less than equal to 40, because they have mentioned that the total batch size is 40 only. So what is to maximize the profit? So basically, what is the profit? Objective function is basically 100x plus of 80y, and we have to maximize this, the number of units of P to be produced. So friends, again I will draw the curve. In this question also, x and y is greater than or equal to 0, because number of units produced cannot be negative. So first equation, let's say this is first equation and this is second equation. First equation is very simple, it is basically a straight line. This is 40, this is, let's say, 40, and this is 40. Now for second equation, first of all I will put x equals to 0. So since x equals to, as I put x equals to 0, the y will become 50. So the first value is 50. And similarly, as soon as I put y equals to 0, x will become 30. So it is 30 somewhere here. So if I draw the curve, so this is the curve. basically. So friends, if I look at the feasible area or region, it is a feasible region. Now we have to maximize profit, so we have to first basically calculate the points. So let's say this is 1 point, which this is 0, 40, this is 30, 0, this is 0, 0, and this point is basically calculated by solving these two equations, which is 5x plus 3y equals 150, x plus y equals to 40. Let's multiply it by 3, you will be getting it as x equals to 15. You solve it, you will get x equals to 15 and y equals to 25. So this is 15, 25. So friends, z at 0, 40 will be 3200, z at 30, 0 will be 3000, z at 0, 0 will be, it will be 0, and z at 15, 25 will be, basically it is 100 into 15, it is 1500, and 80 into 25, it is will coming at 3500. So the maximum value will be at 15, 25. So the number of units of P produced is 15. So this is the right answer. Now friends, moving to the next question. So friends, this is a GATE question from the year 2017. So what the question is saying, maximize z equals to 5x1 plus 3x2 subject to, they have given two equations again, x1 plus 2x2 less than equals to 10, x1 minus x2 less than equal to 8, and x1 and x2 is greater than equals to 0. So what they are saying, in the starting simplex table, so we have to follow a simplex table. X1 and X2 are non-basic variables and the value of Z is 0. So the value of the Z in the next simplex table. So basically friends, this is a very lengthy question. They are asked to format a simplex table. So now before going to solve this question, basically I will try to identify what is the method of solving this particular question. So friends, how to write a simplex table? So see, this is the equation, maximize the function, objective function is given. So now friends, first of all, we will write that equation, which is x1 plus of 2x2 plus of s1 equals to 10. Why s1? Because it is an inequality, and so that in order to remove the inequality, I have introduced a variable s1, which is surplus variable. So now x1 minus of x2 x1 minus of x2 plus of s2 is equals to 8. So friends, similarly the objective function will also change, f5x1 plus 3x2 plus 0 times of s1 plus 0 times of s2. See friends, why 0? Because s1 and s2 is having no participation in the objective function, but since they are in the equation, that's why we have introduced in the objective function also. Now we will calculate basically the value of m and n. For this case, n is 4 and m is 2. So now n minus m, it is 2. So basically these two are non-basic variables, which they have already mentioned that x1 and x2 are non-basic variables, and we will put them equals to 0, and we will calculate the value of two basic variables, which is s1 and s2. Now how do we write the simplex table basically? So first of all, I will write the simplex table. It is written as, let's say this is E. I will explain what is E also. That is, it is called basis first of all, and then I will write the value of EI, then this is basis, then this is x1, this is x2, this is s1, this is s2, this is BI, and this is, let's say, theta equals to BI upon AIJ. So now EI is basically 0 and 0 for s1 and s2. So this is, let's say, where this is 0 and 0. Now x1 is basically 1, see, because it is 1. Similarly for second equation also, x1 is 1, x2 is 2, x2 for second equation is minus 1, s1 is for first equation is, sorry, s1 is for first equation is 1 and it is 0. Similarly, s2 for first equation is 0 and is 1. Bi is basically this value, 10 and 8. So 10 and 8. Now I will first of all calculate zg, or I can write, sorry, before calculating zj, I will also write the value of cj. So what is basically cj? Basically this is, it is this value. So x1 is having 5, x2 is having 3, and s1 and s2 are having 0, 0. Let's see, 5, 3, 0, 0. Now I will calculate the value of zj. Zj is basically summation of ei into aij. So friends, what is ei? Ei is 0 and aij is this values. These values are eij's. So it will be becoming 0, 0, 0, 0, because ei is only 0, 0. So it will coming 0, 0. Now I will calculate delta j. Delta j is basically cj minus of zj. So cj is 5, zj is 0. So it is 5, 3, 0, 0. So now for delta j, maximum positive value, basically we will first select the column. So this is the column now selected. Now we will calculate theta I. Theta I is basically 10 and 8. We will select the minimum positive value. This is the minimum positive value. So this is a replacement row. This is a replacement column and this is a replacement row. So this is the value. So we will try to keep this value, and then we will try to eliminate, convert it into zero by performing row multiplication or row subtraction or row addition, any method. So now friends, moving to the next page, because this page is not sufficient. Similarly, again I will write the table like EI basis, it is x1, x2, s1, s2, bi, theta I equals bi upon aij. So now friends, ei will become 0 and this will become 5. Basis now will be having, it will become s1 and this will become x1, because now this is replaced, s2 is outgoing variable. So now x1, since it will have to be 0, and x1 is 1. So now while performing these operations, what I have done, I have basically subtracted r1 is to r1 minus of r2. So now x2 is basically, now it is 3, it is minus 1, s it is 1, it is 0, it is minus 1, 1, it is 2, and it is 8. And similarly, if you 2 by 3, and it is minus 8. Now cj is again 5, 3, 0, and 0. Now zj will change. Now zj will become 5, it is 0 into 3, and it is minus 5. It is 0 and it is 5. Delta j is now, you will say 0, it is 8. Now it is 0 and it is minus 5. See friends, what they have asked in this question. In this question, they have asked the value of z in the next simplex table. So this is the first simplex table. So in the next simplex table, what is the value of z? So now friends, the value of z in the next simplex table is, x1 is having a value of 8. This is x1 equals to 8. And then so the value of z is basically 5 into 8, which is 40. So the right answer to this question is 40. So this is the right answer, is 40. Now moving to the next question. So now this is a great question from the year 2018. So what the question is saying, the minimum value of 3x plus 5y. So what is the minimum value of 3x plus 5y? Again, this is a simple LPP question. I will first plot the curve. 3x plus 5y is less than equal to 15. So when let's say first of all x is 0, so y will be 3. So let us see, this is 3, and when y is 0, x will be 5. so x will be 5. So I will try to plot, draw the line. So this is, let's say 3x plus 5y equals 15, and this is less than, so this is the area. Now the second equation. So what the equation is saying, 4x plus 9y is less than equals to 8. So let's say this is x equals to 0. First of all, I will put x equals to 0. So y is 8y9, so it is less than 1 also, 8y9. Similarly, y equals to 0, x is now coming as 2. So this is the next line, next curve. So again, it is less than, so this is the area. Now the third equation. The third equation says 13x plus 2y is less than equal to 2. So when y is 0, x is basically 2 by 13, it is again much smaller value, and for x equals to 0, it is y equals to 1. So this is the point. So it is the this equation. So this equation is basically 4x plus 9y equals to 8, and this is 13x plus 2y equals to 2. So the feasible solution is basically this area. But friends, if you look at the point, this is 0, 0, this is 0, 8 by 9, this is 2 by 3, 0. You need not have to calculate this value. Why, friends, I am saying this? Because they have asked the minimum value, and the minimum value will be at this point 0, 0, origin, because any other value will give a positive value. If you consider this coordinate or this coordinate or this coordinate, it will give something positive, but this coordinate will giving 0 value, and it is satisfying all the above equation. So the minimum value is 0 for this question. Now moving to the next question. So friends, this is a gate question from the year 2018 set 2. So what the question is saying, the problem of maximizing z equals to x1 minus x2. So this is the objective function. The constraints are x1 plus x2 is less than equals to 10, x1 is greater than equal to 0, x2 is greater than equal to 0, and x2 is less than equals to 5. So again, friends, plot the curve. So let's say this is x1, this is x2. So x2 is equals less than equals to 5. So this is the area, and this is 5, and this curve is x2 equals to 5. Similarly, x1 is greater than equal to 0, and x2 greater than equals to 0 will be this part of the curve. Now the third equation is x1 plus x2 is less than equals to 10. So basically, friends, this is 10, this is 10. So now, friends, this is the value. So if we look, so this is the region less than equals to 10. So if you look at the values, this is the curve, this is the region, feasible region. So now if you look at the curve or the graph, we will see that this particular question is having only one solution, because only one, either this or this or this or this point will only give the maximum value. So friends, if you have any doubt, just calculate it. It is 0, 5, it is 0, 0, it is 2, 10, 0, and if you solve it, it is 5, 5. So now if you put the values, that is, it is z here will be 0, z here will be 10, z here will be minus 5, and z here again will be 0. So the maximum value is here, z equals to 10. So it is having only one solution. So the right answer is B, one solution.